My name is Charles, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to attach the Visual Studio Debugger to your Unity builds. That way, you can fix bugs that only appear on the devices that your games actually run on. Have you ever heard the phrase, "works on my machine"? It's pretty common amongst programmers because some bugs just don't show up during development. Dev PCs handle lots of computationally heavy tasks, so they tend to be pretty high-end machines. But the devices your games actually run on, the ones your players own, aren't always going to be that great. And even the ones that do match your specs can contain hundreds of variables that all affect the way your games run. Luckily for us, the debugger in Visual Studio has the ability to attach to instances of your game that aren't running in your editor. As long as you've built them correctly and configured your environment properly, you can debug your games on any device you want. Let me show you how. Here's a simple project that you may recognize from our other videos in our debugger series. It runs just fine in my editor, but I'd like to see how it fares on my low-end laptop. Now, I could just install Unity, download the project, and run it directly on my laptop, but that wouldn't be a true test of how the game would actually perform in production. To do that, we'll need to create an actual build and run it on the device, which we can do by clicking on File, then Build Settings. The Build Settings window gives us tons of control over how our game is built. We can add and remove scenes that will be included in the build, choose the build's platform, and toggle a number of options that will change the way the build functions. For the purposes of this video, the option we're interested in is Development Build. Depending on the platform, Development Build will give you access to a series of options that we can use to profile and debug our game once it's been built. The only option we need to worry about now is script debugging. This option will allow us to connect the Visual Studio debugger to our build. So let's go ahead and enable it now. And that's the only one we need to enable for now. So next, we'll click on Build and choose a place for our build to live. Next, we need to transfer the build to a device that we want to debug on. For me, that's my laptop. So I'll go ahead and do that now. Just make sure that whatever device you use is accessible on your network. That could mean running it on the same network, or that you've opened up the necessary ports and configured the firewall to allow the debugger to connect. But more on that later. I've transferred the build to my laptop here, so let's run it and move the character to a safe position so we can connect the Visual Studio debugger. Back on my dev machine, I've opened our project up in Visual Studio. Let's set up a breakpoint so we have something to debug. I've made quite a few changes to this class and should probably confirm that they still work in production. So let's add a breakpoint to the top of this function here. It gets called fairly frequently, so it'll make for a great test case for our remote debugging process. Now we can start the debugger. At this stage, we'd normally just click the Attach to Unity button and be ready to go. But in this case, we'll need to locate the running build on our network and tell Visual Studio to attach to that instead. To do that, first we need to expand the Debug menu and then click on Attach Unity Debugger. This will give us a list of all the Unity debugger instances that our dev machine currently has access to. Each row displays the project name, machine name, type, player or editor, port, and finally, some extra information, which sometimes contains the process ID. Now, if you don't see your instance in this list, you can just click on Input IP and manually enter the IP address of the device that's running your build. If you still don't see your build in the list, then Visual Studio probably can't connect to it. There are a few reasons why this happens, but the most common is your firewall. Firewalls are designed to protect computers from malicious connections. They do this by blocking traffic from certain hosts and disallowing connections on certain ports. Unity's official documentation has an entire page dedicated to setting up your environment for remote debugging sessions. If you encounter any issues, I recommend reading through the troubleshooting section to help solve your problems. However, once you do see your build in the list, all you have to do is select it, and Visual Studio will automatically start the debugger. And look at that, the debugger has already paused the execution of our code on our breakpoint, and we have access to all of the amazing features that are available in the Visual Studio debugger, just as we'd expect. And that's all there is to it. When you finally build and distribute your game, there's no telling how it'll respond to the large variety of devices that your players will run it on. However, when bugs do occur, you can attach the debugger in Visual Studio directly to the devices that cause them, or at least to devices with similar environments. And the best thing is, it works the same way across all Visual Studio products. So, whether you're using Visual Studio, Visual Studio for Mac, or Visual Studio Code, be sure to take advantage of these powerful time-saving features.